The key to the secret of the messenger is given in the Bible, but very few will ponder upon it and reason it out for themselves. The key is in the words, I am Alpha and Omega, I am the first and the last. Can that mean, I came only for a time, and then I was called Jesus, and only then did I give a message? I spoke neither before nor after that time. Alpha and Omega means first and last, always, continually present, never absent from the beginning of creation to the end. God is seen in the one who glorifies him. But if our hearts are closed, even if we wait for a thousand years for the messenger to show himself, we shall never find him. The message is like a spring of water. It rises and falls and makes its way by itself, so that no one can make an imitation of it. If the message is true, it will always make its way to the end of the world. It is always so with the message of God. But those who wait, may wait. It is their destiny to wait, and one cannot help them. They waited while Jesus Christ came and went, and they still wait and will wait forever, and yet he has always come to the individual, to the multitude, to the nation, to the race. He came and spoke to the whole world, but did he come with drums and trumpets? No, he came in the humblest guise, in the most unassuming manner, as our brother, our servant, our friend, our equal. Man, because of his devotion, has called him Lord, but he said, call me not good. I am like unto you. It is not his absence that keeps man in ignorance. It is man's own closed eyes. The master has always been present, but man knew him not.